Trials come both left and right, and in the center I'm now standing. Not a trace of hope inside, and I hear world raindrops, universe beneath the ground. So Lord, I call you today. Please don't pass. Storms of fear,
hallelujah,
now surround me. Failing heart is all I see.
Broken
dreams bring painful memory. Request forever back with me. Still I know
you're standing near me.
I don't need your hands in mine. So Lord, I got you
together for her this morning.
Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Raise those hands. Close your eyes. Hallelujah. A moment time out and begin to love your Father. Begin to glorify God. He's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. He's excellent this morning. Hallelujah. Don't let anything hinder you. Don't let anything stop you from worshiping God. Give him the glory. He has something for you. You got to reach out to receive it. You got to reach out and pull it down. Come on, church. You got to praise him. Oh, glory to God. He's worthy to be praised. He's excellent this morning. His name is Jesus. He's highly exalted. We bow down before him. We give him the glory. Close your eyes and just give him some worship. Let your spirit praise him. Let your inner man glorify him. Let the Holy Ghost glory to God. Fall afresh this morning. We worship you, Jesus. We worship you, King of Kings. We worship you, Lord of Lords. This is our reason together, is to worship the Lord, is to glorify the King. Hallelujah to your name. Hallelujah, Jesus. You are so great. You are highly exalted. We bless the name of Jesus. We bow down, oh God. Our spirit praise you. Our spirit adore you. We glorify this morning. Oh, Jesus. Thank you, 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 thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the Most High God. Oh, Jesus of mercy. We lift you up and we place you in the highest place because you are the great high priest. We place you high above all else as we bow to you. As we bow to you, as we bow to you, as we bow to you, and we worship at your feet. We worship God. We worship this morning. Nobody knows like you know. Nobody understands like you understand. But we give you praise. We give you glory. We give you glory. We give you worship. We give you worship. All hail King Jesus. All hail Emmanuel, King of Kings and Lord of Lords, bright morning star, and throughout eternity, we just want to praise you. We just want to praise you. We just come to praise you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Praise God. God bless you this morning. God bless you. Turn to your neighbor. Look them in the face. Hold them by the hands. Praise God. And let them know this morning that Jesus is going to fix it for them. Turn to them and talk to them in the spirit. And tell the person, Jesus is going to fix it for you. Oh, Holy Ghost of God. He knows how to fix it. He knows how to turn it around. He knows how to transform life. But no matter what it is, he's gonna fix it today. He's gonna fix it this morning. He's right on the job even now. If you can see him, the Spirit is here doing his own thing. He's here working it out for you. He's here changing it around. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. He's gonna fix it for somebody today. Jesus is gonna fix it. He's gonna mend it. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you. God bless you. Kindly have your seats. Praise God. It's a joy to be in the house of the Lord once more. Not seeing anyone, but seeing Jesus Christ. Because he's our reason to be here today. And I just want to bless the Lord, as David said, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. And we have all right to praise him. Is that amen? We have all right to glorify God. Sometimes we allow circumstances and situations to hinder us from praising him. But you better get ready to press past your circumstances. You better get ready to press past your Goliath. You better get ready to press past your Jericho wall and praise God anyhow. Whether the devil wants you to praise him, Lord Jesus, have mercy, my God. You better get ready to praise him. Because when you sing and shout, your Jericho wall will crumble. When you sing and praise God, your Jericho walls will come down. Lord Jesus, have mercy. You better get ready to bring down Jericho wall. Jericho wall is a hindrance. But we go and praise God anyhow and see Jericho wall crumble in our presence. Is that amen? Amen. Is that amen? Amen? Just call his name.
Jesus.
Just call his name.
Jesus.
Just call his name.
Jesus.
Praise God. Praise God. No Jericho wall is not higher than God. God can bring them down. Hallelujah. Praise God. I want to take the time out to extend special greetings to my Bishop Dr. Delford Davis, his wife, Minister P. Davis, all the ministers, praise God, prayer mothers, officers, members, visitors. Praise God, both those that are worshiping with us here today and those that are in our viewing audience. We want to say to you this morning that Jesus is alive and well. And anyone you see, just tell them for me that Jesus Christ is alive and he's doing a great thing. God bless you this morning. We are so happy to have you worshiping with us this morning. It's a great joy to know that we can come together like we are today. And we are here for one common cause and just to lift up the name of Jesus. We are not here because you have a problem. We should not be here because you have a condition. We are here to worship. And when we worship, God will meet our condition. Is that amen?
Amen?
Hallelujah. And he will supply your needs according to his riches in glory. Praise God. And as a man at that, can I just see those who are coming for the very first time? Could you stand, please? You are attending this first Wednesday's fasting for the very, very first time. Oh my goodness. Special welcome to you. Special welcome to
our first timers. It's not so you clap them, man. It's not so power faith do it. Put your hands together and clap our first timers that are here. Praise God to worship the Lord with us. And we extend a very, very warm welcome. Praise God to you. We want to let you know we are blessed to have you worshiping with us this morning. And all that you can get, please, it is available, so take it. Is that amen? If it's salvation, take it. If it's strength to carry on, take it. Anything that you need this morning is in the house, because Jesus Christ is a supplier and he is here. Is that amen? Shout glory. Come on, let me hear you shout glory. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. As you know, in our first Wednesdays, we do have different music ministries, and we are always being blessed by those who present those ministries to us, because they are presented under the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Is that amen?
Amen.
Praise God. If we gather like we are today without the presence of God, without the Holy Spirit, praise God, our gathering would be in vain. But thank God it has not been in vain. We thank God for the devotional exercise, missionary parish, praise God, the prayers that was prayed, the worshipers, praise God. And let me extend it a little further. We thank God for all of you. Praise God. Praise God. You put in your punches, you put in your part, and bless the name of Jesus. The service is what it is today because of your participation and the anointing that destroys the yoke. And if there is still some yokes that are not yet been destroyed, I'm speaking with the authority, they are going to be destroyed before you leave here, because the word of God said, because of the anointing, the yoke shall... Do you believe that this morning? Because of the anointing, the yokes shall be destroyed. And I really give God thanks for this these first Wednesdays fasting. Praise God. It has transformed many lives. And it is yet to transform many more. Praise God. Because the anointing is going to remain and abide in this, are these first Wednesdays fasting. God bless you. Keep your spirit alive. Keep your mind stayed on the Lord. Keep your eyes on him. Praise God. Because there might still be some enemies that the Lord need to take care of. But we must keep our eyes, like Jehoshaphat said, our eyes are upon thee. Praise God. God bless you. God bless you. And at this, come on, put those hands together if you're clapping them. Clap them. Clap them for Jesus. Hallelujah. You can still do better than that for Jesus. Lift them up above your heads. Come on, put them up there. Beautiful. Clap them for Jesus. Clap them for Jesus. Clap them for Jesus. We give them to you, Daddy. We give them to you. We give worship. Oh, glory to God to you today. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. The Lord bless you. At this time, we are about to receive our first music ministry. Praise God. We appreciate the musicians. Praise God who give us music. God bless you as you continue to play skillfully to the glory and to the honor of the Lord. And our first music ministry at this time, we will receive from Deaconess Victoria Henry. Put your hands together for her as she comes to share that which the Lord has laid on her heart. Praise God. We know that she's going to be a blessing as we continue to pray for her. God bless her as she comes in Jesus.
Looking for answers, you find no way out. You've been trapped in your trials, feel full and down. You see a trickle of sunlight, but you find no way out. Just hold to his promises. He said he make a way. Do that again. Looking for answers. You need a way out. You've been trapped in your trial, full of sorrow and doubt. You see a trickle of sunlight, but you find no way out. Just hold to his promises. He said he make a way. And he make a way in the middle of nowhere. When it seems no one really can, is there by your side? He make a way when Satan is closing in. Don't you give up, don't give in. He make a way right on time. Standing at the Red Sea with no place to go. Pharaoh and his army were closing in. I see Pharaohs and trials, and you see no way out. Just hold to God's promises, and he'll make a way. For he make a way in the middle of nowhere. When it seems no one really can, is there by your side? He make a way when you feel Satan closing in. Don't you give up, don't give in. He make a way right on time. Standing at the Red Sea with no place to go. Pharaoh's army was closing in. They'll soon overthrown. But right out of nowhere came a mighty strong hand. Feel Satan closing in. Don't you give up, don't give in. He make a way right on time. No, don't you give up, don't give in. He make a way right on time. No, don't you give up. He make a way right on time.
Praise God. Put your hands together if you're clapping. clap them for Jesus, man. Anything we do for the Lord, we are to put in our best. Is that amen? It's not that we're really clapping Deaconess Henry, but we're giving glory and honor and praise to Almighty God. And if you believe this morning that God will make a way somehow, praise God. I don't business how dark your situation is. There's a light that is about to shine for somebody. There's a light at the end of the tunnel. Praise the name of Jesus. The devil don't have the last say. It's Jesus of the final say. Because we are his children and we are the sheep of his pastures. Do you enter this morning with a praise? We are to enter in his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Shout a praise today. Come on, shout a praise to the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Don't give in. Don't give up. One little songwriter said, "Reign, Jesus, reign. Reign, Jesus, reign. King of Zion, Judah's lion, reign, Jesus, reign. Reign, Jesus, reign. Reign, Jesus, reign. King of Zion, Judah's lion, reign, Jesus, reign. Hallelujah. 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 Every time we talk about Jesus, we feel good. Is that amen? Every time I talk about Jesus, I feel good. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. At this time, praise God, we're going to be having another music ministry. Praise God. And I want you to open up your spirit as she'll be coming to give us just one of her song, this time none other than, praise God, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Okay, God bless you. I want us all at this time to receive Sister Kerrian Beckford Thomas as she come to do one of her song for us. Put your hands together and make her welcome. Praise God.
Bless the Lord. Just raise your hands and give the Lord a praise. Come on, just raise your hands and give the Lord a praise. Somebody just shout a hallelujah. Glory to God. Father, we worship you even now. Hallelujah. Lord, we love you even now. Thank you, Jesus, for your presence. Thank you, Jesus, for your awesome presence. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, just give him a praise. Just give him a praise. Just give him a worship. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on and worship the Lord. Bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. How many know about the love of God this morning? How many know about the love of God this morning? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, one songwriter says, when he reached down his hand for me, I was lost and undone without Christ, without God or his son, when he reached down his hand for me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The love of God is greater far than tongue or pen can ever tell. It goes beyond on earth a queen.
the queen. And every one of us, every one of us, a scribe by trade. As he died for my sins. Oh, remember the love of God. For a minute this morning, just reflect on the love of the Almighty God. For the Bible says that he so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Oh, that we might have life and that we might have it more abundantly. The scripture says, hold all the depth of the riches, both of the wisdom and knowledge of our God. Oh, his ways are past finding out this morning, because of the love that he has for us. That is why we are here today. And I know you've come for a healing. I know you've come for a deliverance. I know you've come for a breakthrough. But if you just take a minute and just thank the Lord for his love, if you just take a minute and just reflect on what he did on Calvary, if you just take a minute and just say, Jesus, I love you. Oh, not because of all you've done, not just because of the clothes you've given, not just because of a roof over my head, but because of who you are, because you first loved me, because he stooped low, because he condescended to us who were of low estate, because he thought himself to be nothing, so that we could be something. Hallelujah. Come on, just think of the love of God this morning. Oh, love of God, how rich and pure, how measureless and strong.
Just stand with me and just Lift up your hands, close your eyes. Come on, man, think about the love of God. Greater love, the word of God said, no man than this, that a man laid down his life for his friend. God, it not been for the love of Jesus, you and I would not be here this morning. Raise those hands, open your mouth, begin to give him thanks, begin to praise him, begin to adore him for his love. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised this morning. He's excellent and he's highly exalted. Lord, we praise you for that love. When you reach down your hands, we were way down, we were lost, but we want to thank you this morning. We want to praise you that you look beyond our fault. It should have been me, but thank you, Jesus, you took my place. And this morning I am giving you worship and thanks because of what you have done for me. Yeah, my mother could not have done it, my father could not have done it, but I thank you, Jesus. My soul say thanks when I was shut up and forgotten, but God, you reached me where I was, and I just want to bless you, Jesus. I just want to praise you for the plan of salvation. I want to thank you for the blood that was shed on Calvary's cross, and because of that, God, you reach our hearts, and look what is happening here today. We wave our hands in worship and in thanksgiving giving to you this morning because of your blessing in abundance, because of the salvation plan. And I was in that plan, and I want to thank you. It could have been someone else. You could have called others and saved them and bypassed me, but I thank you. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you. I thank you, Jesus. Had it not been that you saved me, I don't know what my life would have been. But I want to thank you this morning. I want to thank you from the depth of my heart. I want to worship you, Jesus. I don't know what you come for, but I just come to praise the Lord. I just come to give him thanks. I just come to worship him. I just come to exalt him, because he is worthy. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Put your hands together and give the Lord. Boy, look how many of us are here. Put your hands together. Do it in the spirit. Clap them in praising God today. Oh, glory to God. The love of God so rich, so far. God bless you. God bless you. You may be seated. We want to thank, praise God, Deaconess Victoria Henry. Praise God for her number. And also Sister Carrion Beckford Thomas to remind us, praise God, that God is still there. It doesn't matter what happened. Praise God, we should not give up, because God will come through for us, and the love of God is so great. Praise God. At this time, we will be hearing some more of the love of God, how he has protect and cover and shelter and deliver and set free, how he has given victory. And you know that one person victory is all of us victory. So when one receive a victory, all of us should rejoice. Is that amen? And the word of God says, one weep, we should all weep with such person. But this morning we are rejoicing. Praise God, and we are sharing the victory, because the victory of my brother or my sister, it belongs to me as well as it belongs to all of us. So at this time, we will be blessed with a victory testimony coming to us from Missionary Johnson. Put your hands together, make her welcome as she share with us really the great love and protection of God. Praise God. God bless.
Not my own, I belong to Jesus. I'm not my own, I belong to Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm not my own, I belong to Jesus. Lord. Do it with me one more time, believers. I'm not my own. I belong to Jesus. I'm not my own. I belong to Jesus. Glory to God. I'm not my own. Hallelujah. I belong to Jesus. I'm not. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Belong to Him. This morning, believers, I'm rejoicing. Glory to God, because I'm not my own. And because of Jesus, I can rejoice. Glory to God. God has kept me. He has made a way for me. 27 years ago, I accepted Him as my Lord and my Savior. And I have no regrets. I have no regrets. Hallelujah. If it had not been for the Lord on my side, you'd be planning funeral. Glory to God. You'd be considering what to sing, what to wear to Missionary John's funeral. But to God be the glory. I am still here. Glory to God. Rejoicing in the God of my salvation. Rejoicing for life. Glory to God. I'm alive and well. Glory to God. You know, the week before a convention, the Tuesday, I was on my way over, and I stopped at a sister's house to buy bread. She has a bakery. And she said to me, "Sister Johnson, hold on there a little." I said, "Me can't wait till I come. I have chicken in the van and I can't wait." She said, "Hold on a little bit." I said, "When I come at evening, you tell me what it is." She said, "Holy Ghost, send me to pray for you." I said, "All right, me in no hurry again." And I went in the van and I sat down and I said to my husband, I said, "Frank, Sister Rossi said she wants to pray for me and the van. Cover the van under the blood." And me in no hurry again, because I know what pray again. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And that sister went and she put on whatever she put in on, and she come out because she wasn't properly dressed at first. And she came out and she went around the van and she prayed and she went around the van. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah to Jesus. Believers, Job in Job, Job, glory to God, Satan desired Job. Glory to God. And he went before God. God said, "You consider my servant." I think that's exactly what happened to me. God said to him, "You consider my servant, Leslie Johnson." And he would say, "Yes." Glory to God. But I thank God for the prayer of the saints. Glory to God. I thank God that before convention, we had that special fasting and prayer. Glory to God. I thank God for the covering of God. And you know, the Friday after that, we were around the back, still making preparation for convention. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And the man came to fill the tank around here. And I went up to him, talking about the water situation. I was saying to him, "I hope it's good water, clean water you're putting in that tank, because sometimes we might have to drink it." And I hear creak, 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 that the board that it was set up on was coming down. I said to her sister, "You hear a sound?" She said, "No, she don't hear none." Anyway, I stepped back. Believers, by a step back, the 650 gallon, glory to God, tank of water came down and wet up everybody that was there. Flood out all around here. But praise God, Satan still didn't get the victory. Glory to God. Because guess what? We just laugh and rejoice. Glory to God. Who to go home with? Go home with. Who to change clothes clean? And tomorrow morning we were back on the job again. But he still never finished. Glory to God. He still had a plan for me. Glory to God. But I am under the blood of Jesus. I am under the blood of Jesus. And no devil, no demon from the pit of hell can get my life. Glory to God, because I belong to Jesus. We were on our way to town, hallelujah, to purchase things for convention. Believers, when I look in my mirror, I see a trailer quite near to me coming, recklessly coming. Glory to God. I look on the other side, making sure that the other side, my right hand was clear before I go over. Before I could go over into the other lane, I hear a cushion on my back. I hear a touch in the back, and believers, I couldn't control the van again. I saw the van just got two sides, until it just flick over on the side and run on the side, gone. But believers, before I thought, we were singing and praising God to market. Glory to God. We were on our way to market, praising God. Hallelujah. Three of us. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We were praising God. The van turned over on the side and us running all the way without control, and then till it come to a halt. I said, thank you, Jesus. All when the van stopped, I said, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Believers, I don't have a scratch. I don't have a scratch to show. The other sister don't have a scratch. But number three, she have a little bruise on her hand. Glory to God. One got a little bruise. But this morning, I'm happy. I am happy. I'm alive. I'm alive. I'm alive. I can praise my God. I can glorify God. I can tell others about the love of Jesus. He brought me out. Jesus brought us out. Jesus saved our life. Glory to God. I am happy with Jesus. I am encouraged to go on. The trailer man run, but he can't hide. God is gonna bring him to justice. God bless you, I mean well. Bring my strength. I'm gonna continue with Jesus. No devil, no demon, no demon. Here is number two. Glory to God. No demon is gonna stop us. Glory to God. We're gonna work for God while it is day, because we know night is coming when we won't be able. Glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus. I am one of them. Glory to God, and to God be the glory. Great things he has done. Glory to God. When I went to hospital, glory to God, the gentleman said to me, say, you know one of them doctor now, cause emergency after people who get gunshot, cut, blood and all, so me no one. So if you go back out, me can't stay until next year, them time. Yeah. To God be the glory. Glory to God. I was so engaged with God that morning. Glory to God. I was singing and praising God in that van. To God be the glory. Never know that what was going to happen, but God kept us out and he keep us alive. And we are thankful to continue, praise God, to worship God and to praise, give him all the glory. Praise God. Continue to pray for us. We mean Jesus. We mean business for the King.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Show thank you, Jesus. Come on, show thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. This is where the word of God said, the angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear God and deliver them. The devil meant it for evil, but God turned it around for good. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide. Lord Jesus, have mercy. We rejoice with our sister today. God is a present help in the time of trouble. Put your hands together for victory. Clap your hands for victory. Clap your hands for deliverance. Jesus, do it again. He brought me out of the miry clay. And he put the feet on a rock to stay. He put a song in our hearts to sing. Songs of praise. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Jesus is good. Jesus is our protector. Praise God. Hallelujah. God bless them. God bless them. And thank God for the victory. Praise God. At this time, we do have a special guest with us. Praise God, who the Lord has blessed to be among us today. And he also will be sharing his music ministry with us. And I speak of none other as that special guest is Brother Edwin Myers. And he will be coming to us at this time to bless us with his number. Put your hands together. Receive him as he come to share. In Jesus' name, amen.
Praise God. Today, I just want to greet the Spirit of God and greet Bishop Davis and Minister Davis and all the ministers and all the members and all the visitors in the blessed name of Jesus. Praise God. It's the first I've been into the first when the fasting service, but I'm not a stranger here, amen. This is one of my home, you know. All right, thank God I'm here today, amen. And I just want to share these songs. They are pretty new. Praise God. These songs are my pre-release album. And I just want to share it with you today. The first one is Your Time Will Come. No matter what you're going through, sometimes it seems like nothing now go on, you know. But don't give up. Your time coming. Jesus. Yeah, the darkest part of the night is just before the break of dawn, when your victory is not far away. Won't it look like your hopes are all gone, while there are others who have never been molested, as Satan trying to keep you down. But by the grace of God and the faith in you, don't give up, cause your time will come. Your time will come. The grace of God and the faith in you, don't give up, cause your time will come. Yes, it will. I know it will. Hannah, a woman of God, who despised because not having a child, unspokenly she prayed to the Lord, who described as drunken and wild. She fasted and cried night and day, believing that her time would come. She never stopped praying, she always believing, until the good Lord gave her a son. So your time will come. Hallelujah. Your time will come. By the grace of God and the faith in you, don't give up, cause your time will come. Yes, it will. I know it will come. Joseph was cast into prison, but the good Lord remembered him. Then he offered kindness to his neighbor, getting him out of prison to the king. Joseph told him to mention his name, but his message went all in vain. But Joseph kept praying, he always believing, because he knows that his time would come. So your time will come. Come on, church, your time will come. By the grace of God and the faith, don't give up, 'cause your time will come. Your time will come. Wave your hand for Jesus. Your time will come. Hallelujah, hallelujah. By the grace of God and the faith in you, don't give up, 'cause your time will come. By the grace of God and the faith in you, don't give up, 'cause your time will come. Oh glory. By the grace of God and the faith in you, don't give up, 'cause your time. Hallelujah! Don't give up! Don't give up! Hallelujah! 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 Glory! Glory! All of you who are going through some misfortune in your life, and you just don't know what to do. Lift the music for me, please. Your burdens must be hard. I recommend you to the Lord. He's a friend, and I know He cares for you. Just go on and keep the faith. God has a better place where no rain and no flood can bother you, my Lord. Just hold your head up high and try to smile if you can, for I know that the sun will shine again. I know that the sun will shine again. Come on, believers. Come on, believers. I know that the sun will shine again. You just hope your head up high and try to smile if you can, for I know that the sun will shine again. Some of you have lost your hopes. Some of your family and friends are gone, but try not to worry, because the Lord is on your side. Ha! Hallelujah. Whatever it is you are going through, He'll make a way for you. He's a friend, and I know He will provide. Try not to worry, and don't you fret. God never failed us yet. Just be glad that you know you are His child. Hallelujah! And hold your head up high and try to smile if you can. For I know that the sun, hallelujah, will shine again. Yes, it will. I know that the sun will shine again. Yeah. I know that the sun will shine. Church, I know that the sun will shine again. Glory to God today. Hallelujah. I know that the sun will shine again. Yeah, you just go your head up high and try to smile if you can. For I know that the sun will shine again.
Bless the name of Jesus. Do you believe that today? Just stand to your feet, please, and just wave those hands. Praise God. Just wave those hands for Jesus. And if you know that the sun is gonna shine for you again, you might be experiencing dark clouds, you might be experiencing rainfall, but believe God today that the sun is gonna shine again. Just wave your hands and begin to tell Him thanks. Let your spirit come alive. Let your spirit arise. Hallelujah. And glorify God for your deliverance. I know that the sun is gonna shine again. And somebody's sunshine is today. Somebody's sunshine is right now. You're not leaving here today before you receive it. You're not walking through these doors before you experience a brand new experience with the Lord. Just wave those hands and say, thank you, Jesus. Just wave those hands. I want you to close your eyes. Just close your eyes for a moment and look up, lift up your spirit to His spirit and begin to worship Him. Just begin to glorify God. Hallelujah. Just begin to exalt Him today, because the sun is gonna shine for you again. Father, we thank you. Thank you, great God, for your mercies. Thank you for your deliverance and for your victory. We thank you for the word. We thank you for your servant. And our spirit is open up for you to speak to us. Speak to us, Jesus. Speak to us. Speak to us. Speak to us today, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, God, for Brother Edwin Miles and the numbers he has shared with us today. Your blessings, we continue to wait, because God, you have done it for some of us already, but there are still some who need to hear a word from you. Praise God. God bless you. It was my pleasure, and at this time it gives me great joy, praise God, to present to all of us God's anointed servant, our pastor, the Reverend Bishop Dr. Delpha Davis. Put your hands together. Make him welcome. God bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you all. Well, I believe God has something in store for everybody here today. And let me, before Minister Davis comes to bring you greeting and make her expressions, let me thank those of you who are here, especially for the first time, and certainly those of you who over the years have dedicated this particular day for us to come together to meet with God, and where the Christians are concerned, to intercede on people's behalf. Let me thank you, because this is not about any individual, it's about the kingdom of God. And your interest and your involvement, they mean a lot to what happens here. Various church communities, I believe, are represented here, and this is not about our doctrine, your doctrine, their doctrine. It's about Jesus Christ, who said, "And I, if I be lifted up from the earth, I will draw all men unto me." This is precisely what has been happening, because we are here lifting up Jesus Christ. Amen. Have you been lifting up Jesus? God bless you. Good to have Pastor Smith visiting with us again. God bless you, sir. I'm sure you are being fed and inspired in these services, and we thank God for you being here. Evangelist Edmondson, who lives in the States, is passing through. God bless you. This is the son of the late Pastor Edmondson from St. Thomas. Stand up, son. That preacher who preached some years ago, Sharp Lock, Midnight Sharp Lock, that's one of his sons, and he's also carrying the gospel. Amen. Amen. You got to pray for everybody who preaches the word of God, because it, especially in these days, it's not the easiest task. I was talking with a bishop this morning, and my God, if you're not careful, you know, I heard Missionary Paris was praying, and just coming back to the bishop, that storm clouds or storm of fear now surround us. Where is she? Failing art is all we see, broken dreams and painful memories. Jesus. Quest of help, what? Abide with me. And you could just sense the pulsating beat of the man of God as he expressed himself. A pastor was having open air meeting in a particular area, let me leave it nameless, and three gunmen walk right into the meeting and shot a person right there, right in the midst of the meeting in Hope Tavern. The Reverend Peter Garth, I call name, conducting an open air meeting, and three gunmen marade right in, pull weapon right in the midst of the Christian. Pow, pow, pow. I don't know how worse it can get. Man of God asked me, "Bishop, what on earth are we going to do?" Lift our eyes unto the hills. Friends, come at our head. But I take you further. One of the pastor's son was in a particular building where some of the folks were. And the three gunmen were heading into the building, and a good Samaritan rushed in there and said, "Son, jump the wall!" And the boy scaled this high wall to save his life. They were after him. What a nation! The statistics, some of you who listen to news, you would have heard, and these are not good news. We are in international media right now, but there's no secrecy around the world. It's a global community. The survey was done from 2002 to 2009 of the most violent nation in the earth, where the most murders have been committed. And can you imagine what country came out as the number one murder country? Jamaica. The international media says South Africa was the worst, but no South Africa, no El Salvador, no Colombia, no Afghanistan, no Iraq. And some of those places are places where wars are being fought. Military combat. Jamaica came out as having killed more people than anybody in the other country. Stand with me, please. Hold on with somebody. No, hold any hand. Change. Lift up both of your hands. Father, I stretch my hands to thee. No other help, oh God, I know. If thou shouldst draw thyself from me, Lord, can we call him one more time? Father, God, we stretch our hand. Lord, with the shout, I want just to call upon God for mercy. Just ask him to have mercy. Ask him to have mercy. Come on, no mercy, mercy. Ask him to have mercy. Ask him to have mercy. Let's call on him to have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, 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 have mercy. Mercy, 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 mercy. Mercy, 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 mercy. Lord, have mercy. Yeah, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. God, have mercy. Have mercy upon us. Intervene. Hey, Maluke Shabandalio. Shekamundala Basutia. God, 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 God. Have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy. Mercy upon us, Jesus. Mercy. Oh.
Save us lest we perish. 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 I believe God. Do you believe God? All is not lost. The church is still here and God is still on the throne. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. They shall not prosper. The gates of hell shall not prevail. God bless you. Give our First Lady a hand as she comes to make her valuable contribution to this service today. God bless you. Praise God.
Glory to God. Just for another brief second, just lift both hands in His awesome presence. Everybody that can stand, I want you to stand. I just want you to lift both hands. Your neighbor beside you is not very important right now. It's just you and God this morning. Just lift both hands in His presence. Just magnify God out of the recesses, out of the innermost beam of your soul. Hallelujah. Just love Him and give Him thanks. It never had to be this way. It's because of His grace. It's because of His love. It's because of His mercy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You awesome God. You rule and You reign. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Most High God. We worship You, Jesus. We worship You, God. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, we bless Your name. Hallelujah. You awesome God. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Jesus. Glory to God. God bless you. You can be seated for a few minutes. Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. Thank You, Jesus. I just want to extend a very special greetings, salutation, in the exalted name of Jesus to all those who may be viewing us and to the live audience here, my brothers and sisters. I want to extend a very special greetings to our Bishop, Bishop Dr. Delford Davis, to all of the ministers present. And I just want to say greetings, greetings, and greetings. Just at this time, put your hands together again and give the Lord a big hand. Thank you, Jesus. The songwriters say, how can I doubt a God who holds the universe in His hands? When we look on the sea, glory to God, all those proud waves, they have boundaries. They come so far and no further. God Almighty, He runs the river from coast to coast. And He hushed the sea to sleep. He is the Ancient of Days. He sitteth on the circles of the earth. The Word of God says He is the Potentate God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Who can fathom God? Or who can search him out? Isaiah said, as the heavens are high above the earth, so are his ways above our ways, and his thought above our thoughts. Let us just for a brief second just reflect and see if you can analyze God. When you look for him to come from above, he just spring up from beneath. When you look for him to come from before, he just appear from behind. Oh God, have mercy. Glory to God. Oh Jesus, Jesus. As I reminisce on the word of God, and I said, God, where did all the parts come from to form a baby in the womb? It marvels. It's beyond the human comprehension. And that's why we call him God. And this afternoon, you're here, we are here. And I want somebody to know, God wants to get beyond your limitation. Oh, glory to God. You know, as I lie there on my belly was praying, you may have saw me got up and started to write something. The Holy Spirit spoke to my heart. And he said to tell God's people this afternoon that your son is going to shine again. When I heard him sing the song, I said, God, you confirm your word. The Lord tell me to tell somebody, you have gone through the heat of your summer. You have gone through your autumn. Your leaves have fallen from your trees. You have gone through, hallelujah, your winter season. Oh, glory to God. But the Lord said to tell somebody, it is springtime. You're gonna spring again. You're going to bloom again. You're going to bear again. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God this afternoon. Hey, glory, glory. Glory, glory. The rain has been falling for a very long time. You have not seen sunshine. Oh, glory to God. But the Holy Ghost said to somebody, as the children of God, Noah and his family was in the ark for 40 days and 40 nights, they saw no sun. But God remembered them. God remembers somebody today. The rain, the rain, the rain. The rain is about to cease. Your rain is about to stop. The clouds are clearing up for somebody. And your sun is about to break through the sky again. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I leave this verse of scripture as the Holy Spirit gave it to me for somebody today. The book of Psalms 30 and verse 5. For his anger endureth but for a moment. In his favor is life. Weeping. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy, joy, joy cometh in the morning. Hold on, my child. Oh, glory to God. Hold on, my child. Joy comes in the morning. Weeping only lasts for a night. Yes, Holy Spirit of God. Yes, Lord, I speak into somebody's life. God Almighty, they have gone through. Yes, Lord, hallelujah. And this moment, God, is their breaking point. They have wept, oh God. Oh, Jesus, Jesus. But you tell me to tell somebody, God Almighty. Ay, ay, ay. No, ya, ya, ba, ya, seko. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. You tell me to tell somebody, weeping, weeping. Oh God, only lasts for a night, but joy, joy cometh in the morning. Oh, glory to God. I believe you right now, God. Somebody's coming out. Somebody's breaking forth. The Holy Ghost is mantling somebody. The Holy Ghost, oh glory to God, is anointing somebody. Yes, Lord. The day star is about to appear. Robo Seke. Rabande Shekuria. Oh, Holy Spirit of God. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, yes. You spoke it. I know somebody is here to receive it today, God. Jesus. Oh, glory to God. No yarakasha, rende de keshe, randa la roboko shahaya, randa la rakoshaya nalaha. Stand with me, everybody. Raise both hands in the presence of God. Reach out right now. Reach out right now. Let God Almighty. No de keshe, no yanda la babaya kusiriosa. Hey, hallelujah. Holy Ghost of God, I speak it now, God. Jesus, somebody's night, oh God Almighty, is coming to an end. Oh, glory to God, the day star is about to appear in the name of Jesus. I speak it right now, God. Let that one, God, receive it. Oh, glory to God, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Holy Ghost of God, right now. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes. Manka such a one. Manka, Holy Ghost. Let your anointing. Oh, let your anointing. Rabobokosane. Yadadakashaya. Randadabokosanabahaya. Let your anointing. Hey, 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 hey. Rest upon such a one, God. In the name of Jesus. Loose every stronghold. Loose every stronghold. Bind every stronghold. Yes, Lord. Yes, Holy Ghost. Yes, Jesus. It is in your hands now, God. I've done as you command. You do the work now, God. For your glory and for your honor. We bless you. We bless you. Hey, ha, ha. Hey, Obokosha.
Hallelujah. Lead me, Lord, I'll follow. Anywhere you open up the door, let me know your wisdom. Show me what I've never seen before.
stars shine down on me.
Weep in a door for a night.
Let your love shine through me.
Come to the Lord. Lift your hand and sing it one more time, everybody. Six verses of Acts chapter 28 reads, "And when they were escaped, then they knew that the island was called Melito. And the barbarous people showed us no little kindness." In other words, they showed great kindness. "For they kindled a fire and received us everyone because of the present rain and because of the cold. And when Paul had gathered a bundle of sticks and laid them on the fire, there came a viper out of the heat and fastened on his hand. And when the barbarians saw the venomous beast hung on his hand, they said among themselves, 'No doubt this man is a murderer, whom, though he hath escaped the sea, yet vengeance suffereth not to live.' And he shook off the beast into the fire and felt no harm. Albeit they looked, when he should have swollen or fallen down dead suddenly. But after they had looked a great while and saw no harm come to him, they changed their minds and said that he was a god." Let us pray. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for bringing us together today once again to receive from you in this corporate setting. Lord, there are many persons here who stand in need of supernatural divine intervention. We cannot make supernatural divine intervention. We are but finite human beings. But God, you are infinite, you are divine, and you are able to enter into everyone's circumstance today and minister according to their needs. So right now in this sanctuary, on the internet, around the world, by television, wherever, in the name of Jesus, I pray that these next moments will be spent in your presence. And there shall be a supernatural release of your Holy Spirit. We trust you for it now, God, as you invade our space. And as you defeat the enemy that's warring against us. And give victory to one and all, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Glory. Our message today from this 28th chapter of Acts, the first six verses, comes under the theme, God will give you victory over your vipers. Victory over those vipers. Oh, praise God. victory over that viper. Victory over those vipers. God will give the victory. Lift your right hand and say, in the name of Jesus, I claim my victory over every viper that's trying to take me out. In Jesus' name. Glory to God. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I did say hallelujah. I am believing God today that every viper that's trying to take you out, God will give you the victory over every one of them. Oh, praise God. And those who are looking and have been looking to see you fall down and die, they will have an indefinite look, a long, futile look. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Somebody praise God if you believe it with me. Lift your hand again and say, every viper shall be defeated in the name of Jesus. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Oh my God, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Viper. Viper is described as a small venomous snake, just between 12 to 18 inches long. It is described as also not only as a small venomous snake, but if you check the Oxford Dictionary, it tells me also that viper is comparable to malignant persons. Malignant persons. So it's not only a venomous snake from somewhere hiding out under the dry bushes or hiding out under the green leaves, but persons who are of wicked intentions. Oh God of heaven. Persons who want to see you fall. Persons who want to see you destroyed are comparable to vipers. So today, whether it be a snake or whether it be a person, God help you. Because every believing person is going to get the victory over you today. God, if you settle that in your spirit, if you ever settle that in your spirit, woo, somebody praise God. Not only a malignant person, but it also refers to a treacherous person, a dangerous person, a person who is comparable to a concealed pit. Have you ever seen a concealed pit? You think everything is smooth and level and surface is good, but when you make a step, you realize that concealed under that surface is a pit that is well dug and hidden. Treacherous people are like a concealed pit. Bishop, you can't preach like that today. Well, God help me in this church. I'm going to preach. Oh, God of heaven. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let me tell you David's experience about treacherous persons. David said, if it had been an enemy that reproached me, then I would easily understood, because that's what enemies are for. Are you not with me here? But it was not an enemy. It was my own acquaintance, my kinfolk, whom we walk together and sing together, even worship together and eat together, maybe pray together, maybe work together. It was they that lifted their heels against me. That's a treacherous person. Dangerous. But in Jesus' name, every viper, give him praise. Hallelujah. When you check it out, they all refer to something that is very dangerous, something that is deadly, something that is life-threatening. Viper kills. Vipers kill. Come on, somebody. Tell your neighbor, vipers kill. Vipers are not bedfellows that you want to hang around with. They are not companions you want to associate with. Vipers will kill. Oh God, help us in this house today. Job says, the viper's tongue kills. Job chapter 20 and verse 16, the viper's tongue kills. Isaiah says, that which is cursed breaketh out into a viper. Whatever is cursed of God turns out to become a viper against the people of God. Talk to me here, somebody. So you got to be careful as to where you, amen, make your presence, or who you associate with, or what you invite in your house, or what you have as a part of your association. If it is cursed of God and you are on the Lord's side, it's only a matter of time. It is going to break out into a viper. Isaiah 59 and verse 5. Oh, hallelujah. John the Baptist, in his preaching in Matthew chapter 3, John spared no words when he began preaching concerning deadly, dangerous sinners. John addressed them as generation of vipers. He was not talking to the snakes crawling in the bushes, because God knows. Sometimes you're better off dealing with snakes than dealing with some folks, because you're not going into snakes territory, naturally speaking. You're not talking to me here. So sometimes you stand a better chance where snakes are concerned than where some folks are concerned. Oh God, help me in this church. So John says, oh generation of snakes, who warned you to flee? Jesus, in his teaching in Matthew chapter 12 and verse 34 and Matthew chapter 23 and verse 33, Jesus himself referred to evil people as ye serpents. Ye generation of vipers, how can you escape the domination of hell? So I have said all of that to say this. If it is a viper that hangs out somewhere out there, or if it is a viper in the form of a person who is close by you, God has told me to tell you that he is going to give you the victory over every viper. Come on, somebody.
So after today, I don't want you to fear hell, nor demons, nor devils. Amen. If God is on your side, you are going to trample the enemy under your feet. You're going to rise above them in the name of Jesus, because God is with you, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against you. If you believe it, shout something in this house. Lift your hand and say, no viper, no viper, no animal viper, no human viper, no church viper, no workplace viper, no husband viper, no wife viper, no children viper, no neighbors viper, no employer viper. My God Almighty, no viper, viper. God said, I'm gonna give it a victory, because he wants to bring you out, but you got mission that God would have you to accomplish, and God is going to preserve you from your vipers. My God Almighty, give him praise if you love him. Wave your hand and shout something. Come on, shout something in this house. So today, not tomorrow, today I speak to you boldly. I speak to you boldly because I am very confident as to the power of Almighty God. I'm very confident as to the power that's in the blood of Jesus Christ. I'm very confident as to the power that's in the name of Jesus Christ. I'm very confident of the power of the gospel of Jesus Christ. So with the gospel and the blood and the name of Jesus, that combination today is going to take out your viper and give it a victory. Somebody give him a praise. Lift your hand and say, I shall have the victory. I believe, especially for those who are born again, washing the blood of Jesus Christ, that the enemy has assigned a viper. Come on, somebody. He has assigned a viper to work against us. Assigned a viper to bring us down. Assigned a viper to take us out. Assigned a viper to kill us. Come on, somebody. But I believe God today that a supernatural revelation is going to come upon somebody, and that which you thought was a friend, you are going to find out that it's an enemy. That which you thought was working for you, you're going to find out it's working against you. That which you thought was good, you're going to find out it is evil. And God is going to give you the courage to reject the evil. Somebody praise God in this house. Today, if you have faith in God, the God with whom all things are possible, then you are going to see something happen in your life that has never happened before. Are you getting ready? Are you ready? Do you believe God? Are you trusting God? Victory. Everybody shout victory. God of heaven. Hallelujah. I want you to notice something. That everyone who has a purpose in God, the devil always attacks them. Come on, somebody. Always attack you. And sometimes when you think one thing is over and done, and it's time to get a break, before you blink your eye, another viper spring up somewhere. Am I talking the truth in this house? Look at what happened in the 27th chapter of Acts. Amen. The devil stored up a Euroclydon on the sea. Paul, being a prisoner among 275 other prisoners journeying to Rome, the devil said, "We want this man dead." He wasn't after the other 275 prisoners. Those were real prisoners. Paul was a prisoner of love, a prisoner of Jesus Christ, one who would set men and women free. And the devil wanted to kill him before he got to Rome. And out of nowhere, in the midst of the ocean, a storm named Euroclydon stir up on the sea. And amen, almost devastate everything and everyone. But you see, when God has a plan for your life, he's going to stand by you. Didn't he say, "I'll never leave you. I will not forsake you. I will be with you when you go to the fire. I'll be with you when you go to the flood. I'll be with you when you go to the waters. And the hell shall not prevail against you." God stood by him on the sea. And in the midst of nowhere, an angel appeared unto him. Lift your hand and say, "Lord, I need my angel." Come on, come on, come on. Because sometimes we don't know what to do. We don't know where to turn. It's only a divine messenger from God can tell us what's going on. An angel of God appeared unto him and told him, "Paul, tell everybody stay on board. The ship is rocking, but stay on board. Viper threaten everybody's life, but stay on board. Because no man's life shall be lost. The devil can't kill you on the ocean. God is in control. In the high of your storm, God said, I'll let you find rest." Somebody touch your neighbor and say, "Rest." Tell your neighbor, "Rest." Say, "Rest, neighbor, rest, rest, rest. I know your storm is raging, but rest. I know the billows are dashing high, but rest. I know you feel like you're going under, but rest." In the eye of the storm, God, I feel like preaching here. So no matter what storm clouds may rock the ship of mine, the light of my Savior will lead me safely. Though your ship may be rocking, though the sail may be torn, rest in Jesus. Wait upon Jesus. Trust in Jesus. He will see you through. Tell them, rest. Don't worry, rest. Don't fret, rest. Don't complain, rest. Don't murmur, rest. Yeah, glory. Somebody give him praise in this house. Give him praise in this. Euroclydon. Euroclydon. Some of you wonderful people are experiencing that right now. Turbulence in your life. But God says, "I'm going to come through for you." The words he gave to Minister Davis tied right into this. Weeping may endure for your night. Can you imagine that night on the ocean? But glory to God, the day star will appear. When the morning break. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. So Paul was miraculously saved because of God's supernatural divine intervention. The good hand of God, the gracious hand of God, the merciful hand of God reached out and piloted them even on broken pieces. Somebody praise God here. God say, "You're making it over." Can I make a statement that some of you will consider to be presumptuous? But it is not presumptuous. Listen, there is a time in some of us life when we just cannot die. Oh no, Bishop, you can't say that.
There is a time when you just can't die. Death can't touch you. God had said to him, you will appear in Rome. You will appear before Caesar if God says so. You're not getting this. Somebody praise him if you're getting this. Death could not touch him. He could not have died because missions were not yet accomplished. That's why Moses had to float on River Nile, and no alligator couldn't eat him, no crocodile couldn't eat him, Pharaoh's daughter could not hate him, she had to love him, they could not discern him. And God caused his mother to take care of him in Pharaoh's house. God Almighty. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, I don't know about you, but I know about me. I just feel that I just can't die at this point. I feel death got to pass me by because I got somewhere to go for God. I got some things to do for God. I haven't won all of the victories as yet. It's not over as yet. Somebody praise him in this house. So no matter what happened, God is going to make a way somehow. The lions could not eat Daniel. The fire could not burn Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Woo! If you believe it, lift your hand and say, can't die now. Wow. Boy, if you don't understand that, friend, I'm sorry for you. He just could not die as yet because all his missions and God's divine purposes were not yet accomplished in his life. So death had to pass him by. Oh, Jesus. I feel I want to preach a little here to somebody. Some of you feel you're going to die. You better become a Hezekiah here today and say, God, I need more time to do what you call me to do. Lift your hand and say, more time. More time. More time. Touch your neighbor and say, more time. Echo Shandala. God, I feel the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Now lift your hand and say, enemy, no more time. Viper, no more time. Viper, 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 viper. No more time. Time up. Time up for the viper. Time up for the viper. Time up. Make Shandia. Time up. Male Shamandia, God of heaven. Somebody praise God in this house and trample a viper. Praise God and crush a viper. Woo! Dear God in heaven, I feel the Holy Ghost all over this place. I would to God somebody would praise him. Sit down, please. I did say, sit down, please. So death had to pass him by. At one point, they stoned him in Jerusalem. I'm talking about Paul. And he was left in the street as a dead man.
But he could not die at that point. At one point when the enemies barging on the house to capture him, they had to put him in a basket and open a window and let him down on the other side in the basket. But he could not die. Death had to pass him by. Psalm 118 and verse 17, the psalmist declared, I believe he was in that kind of mode. He said, I shall not die, but live and declare. Though, oh, praise the name of Jesus. Somebody shout his praise in this house. But what we find in these texts, both texts of chapter 27 and chapter 28 of Acts, those texts show how many are the perils of human life. How many are the tragedies that we encounter, especially as we seek to pursue God's will. And how challenging the circumstances will become from time to time. We have just escaped the sea after they had escaped. The first verse of Acts chapter 28. After we have escaped. Come on, somebody. From the sea. Now we are on land. And we thought it would have been easier on land than it was on the sea. Oh no, I can't say this. Please bear with me saying this. Some of you thought it would have been easier in the church serving God than out there in the world. But honey, the reality of it is some things are harder when you begin to serve God. More trials come, more testing come, more enemies arise, more attack from the devil. Brother James Cleveland sings some years ago, I just feel no way tired. I come too far from where I started from. Nobody told me that the road would be easy. But I don't believe. Somebody praise God if you're on. God Almighty. I don't believe he brought me this far to leave me. So if he preserved me on the sea, and trouble takes me on the land, he will preserve me. Somebody praise him in this house. The perils of human life, the tragedies of human life, the variables of human experience, the checkered experience that we have from time to time, especially serving God. But our God. Touch your neighbor and say, our God. Our God gives victory everywhere, whether on land or on sea. Our God gives victory every time. Springtime, summertime, winter time, and whatever time. Time doesn't change the Almighty God. He is the immutable God. Somebody praise him here. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He works every time and every season and everywhere and for every person who trusts him. Under every circumstance, God is a deliverer. Those of you who have received some types of deliverance from the mighty hand of God, just whisper in your neighbor's ear and tell that person, God is a deliverer. Dear God, look there. Look there.
Look at that. Well, somebody didn't hear too well in the right ear or the left ear. Please ask them to give you the other ear, and so they can hear you, tell them again. Did you hear that, friend? How do you know he delivers? How do you know he delivers? How on earth do you know he delivers? I know because he delivered me. He brought me up out of the horrible pit, out of the miry clay. He put a song in my heart. He put dance in my feet. He put clothes on my back. He put food on my table. He put a roof above my head. Okay, Moshe. God, somebody wave your hand and say something in this house. Hallelujah. Some people don't believe you. You need to tell them you ought to have been there. When the Lord saved me, you ought to have been there. When he gave me the victory, when he puts joy down in my soul, wrote my name on the heavenly roll, you should have been there. If you were there, you would join me praising God. You would magnify the Lord with me. You let us exalt his name together. Everywhere, every time, every circumstance, for every believing person, he gives the victory. Oh God Almighty, no one was exempt from the mighty power of Almighty God. Lepers walked in his presence and he delivered them. He walked among the dead and he raised them back to life. Talk to me here, somebody. He walked among the crippled and their crippled legs received strength and began to walk. He walked among the blind and the blind cried out, I can see! He walked among the hungry and he fed them and they had more than enough to eat and to spare. Somebody praise him in this house. What are your vipers today? Victory over every viper. Lift your hand again and say, every viper. For Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and the same today and the same forever. The questions I leave you with today, first of all, is what is your viper? What is that venomous blood sucker who wants to suck your life out of you? I can Shamanda. What is it? Who is he? Who is she? You can't get victory over what you do not know. Come on, somebody. You got to first of all identify. Oh, somebody help me in this house. And when you identify, in order to defeat, you got to confront. You do not defeat an enemy by running from the enemy. Somebody say head on. Come on, somebody. You must identify what is that viper. And when you see it, you don't run. David saw a monstrous viper stood up before Israel and said, I bring down the armies of God. I defy all Israel. David said, who that? I will confront him. Because if you are going to defeat it, you must confront it. You don't conquer what you do not confront. Oh, glory. And David looked on that monster and said, you come to me dressed up with all kinds of stuff, but I come to you in the name of the Lord. Somebody praise God here. What is that viper that threatens your survival? That's what we are after today. We are not going around in circles. We are hitting bullseye in the name of Jesus. Spear fishing we are doing today, not net fishing. Spear fishing. Aim for your target. Oh God, help me in this place. Aim for your target. Aim for your target. What is that viper that threatens your very existence today? What is it? Secondly, where is that viper? Where is it? Is it in your body? Is it in your body? Is it among your family members? Because God knows some of us got some family members that are worse than vipers. Excuse me, please, but I'm talking the truth. They suck your night, they suck your day. Although you're one blood, they want to see you fail and fall and die. Especially those who think that you should not be who you are, as blessed and as honorable and as prosperous and as healthy as you are. Can I preach to somebody here? Whatever the viper is, whoever the viper is, in the name of Jesus. You must get the victory. What is it? Where is it? And I might ask, who is it? Who is it? Who is that viper? Who? Today is D-Day. Deliverance Day. Come on, somebody. We're not playing around. Paul said, I'm not playing with this thing. You don't play with death. You don't play with that which will take your life. It is killed. Kill or be killed. Kill or be killed. Just lay your hand gently on the person beside you and tell them that's what it is. Kill or be killed. Viper is not here to hug up anybody and kiss you and send you to bed and say have a good night. Rest. The devil cometh not but for to steal, and to kill, and to destroy. Tell somebody today is deliverance day. There are vipers in the house, vipers in people's lives. Come on, somebody. Some of you would have been far better off in life today if those venomous beasts were not sucking your life out of you. Talk to me here, somebody. Far better off. Much healthier than you are. Much stronger than you are. More prosperous than you are. More victorious than you are. More spiritual than we are. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on. Hey, my God Almighty, did you say preach it, sister? Somebody shout and praise him down here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody would say, I got murder on my mind. And I won't be charged for murder because I'm killing he who deserves to die. I'm killing that which Jesus died to kill. Somebody shout something here. I'm killing that which Jesus died to kill. Woo! God, I feel the Holy Ghost touching somebody. Down here, down here, down here. Lift your hand and shout murder. God Almighty. Hey, hey, hey. I didn't say suicide, I said murder. I did not say suicide, I said murder. Stop, kill yourself. Stop, kill yourself and kill the viper. Stop, kill yourself. Kill the viper. Stop, kill yourself. Dear God, somebody praise God in this house. Tell your neighbor, stop, kill yourself. Stop, kill yourself. Stop, kill yourself. Kill the viper. Kill the viper. I did not say suicide. I said murder. Some of you killing yourself because of the viper. It's the viper you must kill. There's somebody, kill him, kill him, kill him, kill him. Kill it, kill it, kill it, kill it. Kill it, crush it, mash it, mash it. Trample it, kill it, destroy it. In Jesus' name, get your victory. Get your victory. Woo! Shako mo shandara. Andara baba shakatai. Eke mo shatiri bihuya. Shako mo shanda. Eyako shababa huye. Kill it. Don't kill yourself. Kill the viper. Kill the viper. Paul. Just about to escape the cold and the hunger and break some wood to make a fire, to sustain the fire. Now let me make a point here. The fire was there burning. Paul went to get additional wood to sustain the fire. And the point is simply this, but very profound. Those who benefit from the heat of the fire should contribute to its sustenance by bringing wood. Oh, some of you didn't get that. If you benefit from the heat of the fire, you must contribute wood or fuel, whatever it takes to keep it going. He did not saw himself as this great apostle. He went down to gather sticks. Let me make another point here, because some of us in church, once we reach a certain status, we become bigger than certain thing in the church. Oh no, I can't do that. That's for the janitors to do. That's for the yard men to do. That's for this one to do. Could you too? God help me in this church. The apostle came down. Tell somebody, come down, come down, come down. One holiday that went by recently, I preached at a convention in Kingston at one church just a couple months ago. And I saw the pastor the other day, and he said to me, Bishop, dear God, they gave me a theme to preach on, God's attitude towards the proud. What's that? And the gentleman told me, he said, Bishop, dear God, when you left And over time, some folks began testifying out of their heart. They never knew that they were eaten up by pride. But the message you gave, it got inside of them. They found out how much they were being eaten up and swallowed up by pride. I said that's what the word of God is all about. Somebody praise him. Let me bring it down in 5 minutes, please. So those who are benefiting from the heat and the warmth of the fire, tell your neighbor, bring some wood. Bring some wood. Bring wood, man. You're not bigger than bringing wood to keep the fire, to keep you warm. Let's finish. The fire was burning. And so when Paul picked up the stick and the viper sprang onto his hand, Paul said, thank God we have already built a fire. There is something to take care of this viper. That's why the church of the living God must be red hot. That's why preachers must be red hot. Primaders red hot. Choristers red hot. Everybody red hot. My gosh, the fire must be burning in Zion to take care of vipers. Oh, hey, 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 hey. Somebody show something in this place. Paul says, you ain't gonna kill me. I'm gonna kill you. God's gonna give me victory over you. Because the fire is burning. And what he did, he walked over to the fire. And what he did, he shook off the viper. Shook it off in the fire. And when those barbarians who were looking and have said to themselves, dear God, this man must be some devil, some wicked man, some criminal, some murderer. He just barely escaped death on the sea. And no sooner he arrived on the land of Melita, look at what has happened again. This man must be some murderer. Public opinion, people's perception of some of us. You see, because everybody's free to frame their thoughts and to make their judgment, God help some of us. You're not saying anything there. God help some of us. A bishop said to me only yesterday, Bishop Davis, some things that people say some of us do is only God knows say it's not truth. Because the way how they frame it, the way how they put it, is only God knows say it's not truth. But thank God, God knows. Tell your neighbor, God knows. Murderer just escaped the vengeance of the sea, and here he is about to fall down and die. But after they've looked for a great while, you think it's today some people are watching some of us? Watching to see the downfall. Watching to see the defeat. Watching to see the destruction. Watching to see you fail. Today they are still looking. Some have by now changed their minds. Because they have seen the real power of Almighty God manifesting in your life. They have seen the Holy Ghost. They know you could not pretend and profess for so long. They know that you are for real. They know that you are for real. Somebody praise him in this house. Shook it off. You know.